Hey guys, so we're back.
Hey everybody.
Back with Brother-in-law Hengikihan.
Yep.
So now we're going to get into some more rock.
Absolutely. If Brother-in-law Hank is here, it can only mean rock, right? Among other things, but primarily rock.
When are we going to do disco together?
No, not together. No. You can find a different brother-in-law. No, it's not going to be brother-in-law Hank. If you have another brother-in-law, which I don't think you do, that's going
to... back into doing a video by myself.
Boom, and then do your disco.
Then I can do my disco.
Do your, what is the other music that...
Bee Gees.
But maybe Bee Gees doesn't have to be disco. Bee Gees have so many great songs before there on Saturday night that I would probably do with you because that's some really nice stuff. But
okay.
But yeah, not the disco.
I think most of their songs that, you know.
Yeah. No, if it's going to be disco, I tell you, I went through high school with two buttons.
I know, I don't want to hear it anymore.
Sex, drugs, and rock and
roll.
That's
enough.
And disco sucks. Those are my
Bring
two buttons
back memories.
That I carried throughout high school. So no, I'm still not that.
All right, so now we're going to get into, since last week we did Queen and Paul Rogers.
Right. And just now we did the Five Finger Death Punch, do a Bad Company song. So we're sort of in a Paul Rogers type of mood. So when
because he's in Bad Company.
He's the lead singer for Bad Company.
Okay.
So when you said, you know, the Five Fingers and we were going to do the Bad Company, I said, oh, so let me do another Paul Rogers, since last week we did it with Queen.
Right.
So one of my favorite Paul Rogers solo song, this is from the second solo album that he did with any band, just on his own. In 1993, he did an album called Muddy Waters, a tribute to Muddy Waters. And it's a really cool album because he had, you know, Jeff Beck, he had Buddy Guy, he had Slash. Jeff Beck is one of the greatest guitarists that has ever lived, top five guitarists. Okay. No matter who you ask, his song, he played with Jimmy Page early on in a band called the Yardbirds, but then he's been pretty much on his own. And no matter who you ask, he's always regarded as maybe the top five, in the top five great guitarists. So, I mean, he's in the album, Neil Young from Journey. I mean, he's got all different musicians that accompany him on this particular album. And it's a tribute to Muddy Waters. So it's, doing all of his songs, in a blues rock fashion. So my favorite song from that album, It's with Jeff Beck, and it's a song called I Just Wanna Make Love to You. And we spoke about this song a couple of times a while back when I think it was Dixie who said she liked that version by the Righteous Brothers. And I said, yeah, that's a great version, but to me, this is a more, for me personally, and there's a bunch of people have done this song. The Rolling Stones covered this song. It's a bunch of different bands have done it. So, but to me, I guess being a rocker, a blues rocker fanatic, this is an incredible, incredible version. So I think you're going to like it. I hope you like it. You've never heard this song, obviously.
No.
You never heard of Muddy Waters, probably.
No.
Okay. This song was, it was written by a guy named Willie Dixon, who at the time was Muddy Waters' bass player. You know, Willie Dixon went on to write many, many blues songs. You know, he was incredibly great at great musician himself, but the first version was written for Muddy Waters, and he was known as the father of modern Chicago blues. He's great blues dude, great blues guy or performer. So anyway, so the song we're doing is I Just Want to Make Love to You, and Jeff Beck on guitar and Paul Rogers at the mic.
So. Okay, I can't wait now.
Let's do it.
Let's go.
Yep.
Wait, we need to get a toast.
We need to do a toast to Paul Rogers. She's
Paul
becoming.
Rogers and Jeff.
She's becoming an alcoholic in front of your very eyes, people. So I don't know. Not my fault.
Just drinking when you're here. You know.
Salute. Right.
And it's only a little sip.
But how many little sips do you have?
You ready?
Yep, let's do this. Whoa. blues. Yeah, and the guitar,
and
of
the
course.
Guitar.
Yeah, sure. It's blues,
that was
rock.
So good.
That's.
I love that. I think that's one of my favorite, the rock, like blues rock.
Yeah. Well, there's a lot more that we can do that, you know, from him, from others. But Paul Rodgers was primarily a blues rock singer, you know, and that voice is meant more for the blues, which is partly why he didn't really fit in with the Queen original, you know, their style, which is a totally different thing. But yeah, this is his wheelhouse, you know. Even with Bad Company, or with Free, the band before Bad Company was also a blues rock blues type of thing. So, you know, on this album also Brian May from Queen did a song with him.
Really?
From this album. David Gilmour from Pink Floyd also. I mean, he had a bunch of different great guitarists. You know, Gary Moore, another great guitarist. You know, do songs with him in this album.
Why did you say that? I see the album cover, it says Brian May on it too.
Okay, yeah, well, right, yeah, he's got, right, all the, he lists all
got
the,
all the
right, right, Brian Setzer, who was from the Stray Cats, I don't know if you remember him. Richie Sambora was from Bon Jovi, his guitar player, Richie Sambora.
Oh, we gotta do Bon Jovi,
yeah,
he's so hot.
Neil Sean is from Journey, of course, it's Gary, Steve Miller is one of the, you know, he's another guy that you can do. Steve Miller's got so many freaking songs. Another guy that you can do a lot, you know, from 70s rock, you know? So.
Oh, that was good. Mm. That's good.
Yeah, good stuff. So that's.
Good.
Okay. That's Paul Rodgers. Yeah, no, absolutely.
I like him. Like, we gotta dive into some more Queen and Paul Rodgers.
Right,
he's,
doing
when
a,
he's
Queen,
singing a
Queen
song.
Yeah, no, we spoke about that.
You know,
yeah, I think
gotta
that's.
See how
I think
he's
that's,
doing, you know, how he's.
Right.
Is singing a Queen song. Because
yeah,
you know
yeah,
he's
no,
really good singing the rock and,
right.
you know, the blues.
Right. Yeah, yeah, no, well, that's in the queue.
Yes.
We'll put that in the queue. We'll have
that.
To do him
really
singing,
to
a, singing a Queen song. With
yes.
Queen.
Yeah.
We'll definitely do it. But,
all right, guys. Thanks for hanging out with us. And that was really good. I hope you guys like that.
Yeah, I know the rocker friends out there.
They
a lot of them probably know it. Most of them probably know it. But they'll certainly, you know, they know Muddy Waters. They know the
Rodgers.
I never
heard of that song. I never heard of Muddy Waters.
Yeah, no, like I said, a bunch of bands have done it. Mm-hmm. You know, Muddy Waters was one of these guys that inspired a lot, and we always talk about it, a lot of these rock musicians were inspired by the blues, mm-hmm. right? Muddy Waters has a song called Rolling Stone. Well, that's where the band, the Rolling Stones, got the name from,
okay.
from that song.
Oh.
So, I mean, you know, he was a big influence on them. He was an influence
okay.
on the Allman Brothers. AC/DC, the song You Shook Me All Night Long,
mm-hmm.
well, that's from a lyric from a song that he has called You Shook Me. So, I mean, everybody, mm. you know, in one way or another, is influenced by these
yeah.
old blues, you know. So, it's that's the thing with music, man. Everything comes from somewhere. You know, very few
of
things
course.
Nowadays, and not very few things, musically speaking, nowadays, come from
yes.
the air, out of nowhere.
Yeah.
There are, of course.
Yeah.
But a lot of that stuff comes from
a lot of the
somewhere else.
Artists
influence.
Has, yeah. Mm-hmm.
So anyway, which is the great thing about music, which is why when people say, oh, he's trying to copy that guy, or he's trying to sound.
I don't think it's
you know, I don't go by that. Right.
Unless if it's, you know, like.
Right, unless they don't recognize it and they're trying to rip them off.
And then they say
every
no,
so often.
Yeah, exactly.
Right.
Trying to rip them
right.
off and say, no, it's
but,
not
but whenever they
the
say
same
we,
song or something.
Right, when they
know?
Say, we're doing this song. By such and such,
right, and giving them credit,
they're paying tribute
it.
to
mm-hmm,
those artists,
mm-hmm.
which is great, you know,
yep.
paying tribute to the people who came
exactly.
before you, so
exactly.
who in many ways opened the door for people like
for,
you to
right.
do what you do now.
Like
so
today's
it's,
artists,
it's just all one big happy music family throughout the ages, absolutely. Anyway,
that was really good. Mm-hmm. All right, guys, thank you for hanging out with us, and we'll see you in the next video. Make sure you like, subscribe, and leave a comment below.
That was quick. All right, guys. Thanks for hanging out with us.
I should know that by now.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I should know it too, but I still get stuck in the first part.
Peace out. Make sure you guys stay safe.
Absolutely. Stay safe, everybody. We'll see you next time.
Bye.